Now we'll study group vibrations. The molecule to be IR active should have a permanent dipole moment. If there is no dipole moment change, then it is IR inactive. For example, HCl, there is a permanent dipole moment, so it is IR active, but H2 is inactive. For CO2, dipole moment changes. There is a dipole moment. There is not a dipole moment. For a linear molecule, the vibrational mode is given by 3n-5, and for non-linear molecule, vibrational mode is 3n-6, where n is the number of atom. And scratching mode for linear and non-linear molecule are same, n-1, n-1. For linear molecule, bending mode are 2n-4, and for non-linear, it is 2n-5. For example, for CO2 molecule, vibrational modes are given by 3n-5, that is 3 × 3−5 = 4. And for scratching mode is n-1, so 3−1 = 2. Bending mode is 2n-4, that is 2. For CO2 molecule, when we do symmetrical sketching, there is no dipole moment change. When we do asymmetrical sketching, there is a change in dipole moment. And when we do bending, then also there is a change in dipole moment. Now the IR spectra of CO2 will be something like this. The asymmetric sketching frequency will be more compared to bending. There are four types of bending. One is rocking, then wagging, then scissoring, and then twisting. Rocking is when both the atoms goes on the same side, and here the both oxygen, for example, this any triatomic molecule, then both the atoms are going towards the opposite atom, here in scissoring. And in wagging, they are coming they are going inside the plane. And in twisting, one is going inside the plane and one is going outside the plane. The frequency of scratching is always greater than frequency of bending, and the frequency of AB molecule, if it is single bonded, then it is mu AB upon root 1. If it is the same atoms are bonded by double bond, then it is mu AB upon root 2, and if it is triple bonded, then mu AB upon root 3. So this relation is used for finding the frequency. For example, frequency or wave number, then wave number of C triple bond O is 2130 centimeter inverse, and wave number of C double bond O is, we need to find out. So we know that nu CO upon root 2 is equals to nu CO upon root 3. So here we will put the C triple bond O wave number, and we'll find out the wave number for C double bond O by cross multiplying these values. Similarly, if we know the C triple bond C wave number, it will be it is given as 2240 centimeter inverse. What will be the wave number for C single bond C? So we'll use this relation. Wave number of C single bond C upon root 1 is equals to wave number of C triple bond C upon root 3. Putting all the values and then cross multiplying it, we will get the value of wave number of C triple bond C. Now we will see the frequency decreases when there is an electron donating group. Then the carbonyl frequency decreases because the bond strength of CO is decreases, whereas when we add the electron withdrawing group, the bond strength of CO increases because there is double bond here in CO, so the frequency also increases.